So what we have here is, I mean, I use 50-pound test braid. Can you bump it up to 65-pound test? Sometimes I use 65 when I'm fishing just strictly for trophy fish. But really, when you're eeling, it's, I mean, a lot of times you're just going for a trophy anyway because eels are a gateway to big fish. So I'm really simple. It's a 50-pound test Power Pro here, polymer knot to a 90-pound test barrel swivel. So I prefer the Mustad 94-150 as opposed to the octopus hooks. Most of the guys use the octopus hooks. I like the Mustad. I use 8-0. It's a larger hook. It's a beefier hook. But the main reason is because of the barb. Because the barb is bigger. So when you're casting that eel, the eel will tend to stay on the Mustad more than the octopus, I've found. Because of the barb. It stays on that barb. It can't get off the barb. The octopus, you know, I take out people all the time. I take out new guys, I take out experienced guys. You know, I'm doing a lot of charters all year long, and what happens is with the octopus hooks, guys come back and it just falls off and you lose a lot of eels. Not so with the Mustad hook. So that's the main reason I use the Mustad hook. You know, people talk about, also with the hook, people talk about sharpening the hook. You know, oh, the octopus is much sharper, they say. Well, that's not necessarily true. You go to Home Depot, buy a file, sharpen your hook. It takes 2 seconds. It'll be sharp as the Mustad. I mean, sharp as the Gamagatsu. When you're scraping it, this one definitely catches the nail. So one of the reasons why this is sharper, I think, because it's just a thinner hook. So sharpen. I never had any problems socking this through a 40. You know, people, oh, you bigger fish, it's never going to sock through their mouth. That's crap. You know, I mean, these hooks will go right through a 40, trust me. So I got my 80-pound test. I'm just gonna tie the 8-0 Mustad via improved clinch. That's all I use, man, it works. You don't have to snell it, you don't have to do any of that. If you want, if that's your thing, you can do that. Just an improved clinch with the 80. Wet it. And that's it. I mean, this is the same setup I would use to throw a plug, a darter or anything else. Same exact thing. So only now I got it. I'm set up for eels. The rod I use, you know, I'm fishing like bigger surf. So it depends on where you're fishing. If you're fishing the back bays, you might not want to use this setup. But, you know, I'm fishing mainly the South Shore of Long Island and a lot of Montauk. 90% of my fishing is in Montauk. So what I have is a VS-275 with 50-pound test Power Pro, up to 65 sometimes. And the rod I use is the Lamaglass GSB 1321M. It's a great blank. It's soft enough so when you're feeding the bass, the eel, he's not feeling it so much as opposed to like a stiffer rod. And you can get out any size eel with this blank. So it's a great all-around blank. It's what I use. It's really a basic setup. I have a live eel well. I mean, you can store your eels at home too. I got a 55-gallon aquarium at home where I store my eels. Around the 55-gallon aquarium, I have black all over it. I don't know what it is, like black construction paper all around it. I tape it to the tank. That keeps the eels nice and dark. Now, most people believe that, you know, you need, you know, the darker eel, the better. The blacker the eel, the better. I don't find that necessarily true. I mean, if he's sitting in your white cooler and he's almost white green, I find that the bass like him either way. It's a friggin' swimming eel swimming around in the ocean. This bass sees it, he's gonna hit it. I mean, either way. A lot of guys would disagree with me on that, but that's my experience. So, what I use for my truck, I have a live well on my truck, and so this is Power Bubbles. You can get this in most bait and tackle shops like Bass Pro or whatever. And it's just basically attached, positive, negative. That's it, man. And then I screw it into this, and it's locked down solid. This goes constantly. Truck on, truck off. You're good for days as long as your battery's okay. You don't have to start your truck or anything like that. It's only like an amp. So then you got the tube coming out. It goes into my cooler. And these are live eels. I have a little aerator here. And when you pick out your live eels, you should go to get friendly with your bait and tackle shop owner. Most guys will let you pick out the eels. You want them like anywhere from like, I don't know, 14 inches to like 20 inches, depending on where you're fishing. The back bays, I like them a little smaller. You open surf, I like them bigger because you want that extra weight to cast them. So, now what do you use to take them out in the surf? Well, there's two ways of doing it, really. You can take an eel. You want to grab an eel. Say you're fishing from the beach, just like a sandy beach like we're on right now. This is the lazy man way of doing the eel. I mean, you don't have to carry them out to the surf or anything like that because you're fishing out of your truck, right? So you just take an eel. Just take an eel, put some sand on his head. See, he's going around. It's kind of silly, but get some sand in his eyes. See that sand in his eyes? Now he's gonna mellow out. So now you can just grab him. And then to get him on the hook, you just go through the lower jaw and out the eye socket. And now I just take the sand, get the sand off his eyes. He's ready to be hooked now. See, I'm grabbing him, no problem with the sand. That's the easy way of doing it on the sand. But you know, when you're out on the rocks, usually for me, I'm out on the rocks, I'm not gonna do it that way. So we're gonna do it the other way, where I'm carrying in the bag. I see a lot of guys that have these buckets on the side of their, you know, they carry these freaking big buckets and they get the Brillo pad and shit you read about you're telling me you're gonna be on a rock with a bucket on the side of you, taking a Brillo pad with waves crashing into you, dunking into the bucket now with a Brillo pad. No way, no way. I would not recommend that at all. And they'll say, well, you know, the bag kills them, that's why. It's not true. A small bag will kill your eels. A big bag will not kill your eels. You want a bag about this size where the eels can lay. If you have a little friggin' bag like this, the eels have nowhere to lay and they're all curled up and they're gonna die on you pretty much, you know, quick. And if it's like an August night or something like that, they'll die on you quicker. Or if they're getting hit by waves, you know, they'll obviously die on you quicker. But when they're but the thing is, you attach them to your belt and it's behind you, not in front of you. If it's in front of you, the wave's gonna get hit by waves, and it's gonna damage the eel and they're gonna die quicker. So, you know, it's really all just technique of keeping your eels alive. So I'm gonna do, so I'm just gonna put two eels in here. I got a bunch of them. Whatever, I'll put a couple in there. So, right? Now they're in my bag. Let's just say I'm going out on the rocks wherever I'm going. Now they're attached to my belt. I like this little thing here too. Get an eel bag, like EMS carries some nice bags. They're basically laundry bags, but you know, get a better one. I like this little thing too, because when you open up the bag, you can adjust this so the eels won't come out. I mean, if the bag's open like this, it's a little bit harder and the eels can escape while you're trying to grab one eel. So while you're walking with the bag, say you're walking a mile into somewhere, you don't want to carry it like this. You want to carry the bag like this with the rod on your shoulder so the eels aren't flapping around against your leg and damaging your eels. So you want to carry them outside like that, right? All right, so when you're walking with them, or when you get to your rock, what you want to do after you put the eel on is just put it in your belt. I like to put them behind my belt, so if the wave hits them, it's going to damage them. Sometimes I forget to do that. I put them in front, and, you know, they get damaged a little quicker. So then you want to take it off. The first thing you want to do, say I'm on a rock or on a sandy beach, really. You want to get your hook ready for the eel. So I'm going to take this off the roller. I'm going to give myself some slack like that, right? Now I got the slack, so now I can grab the hook without a problem. I'm not screwing around with the hook, trying to get the, it's easy. And by the way, people will say, oh, you gotta slap the eel, you gotta do all this crazy shit. You don't have to do that. You want, the point of having a live eel is to have a live eel, right? And I heard other people say, well, I don't like them around the rocks because they dive into the rocks and then they lose the eel. To me, that's like, what are you talking about? That's what an eel's supposed to do. That's why they're great around the rocks, because they're diving into the rocks where the bass are. If you're fishing rocks with an eel, all you do to keep them kind of out of the rocks is reel a little bit faster, just like a plug, just like a bucktail. You reel a little faster to keep them out of the rocks. They won't go in the rocks. If you know how to fish it, they won't go into the rocks. But you want them close to the rocks. You want them kind of going in there where the bass are. So here's how you do it. Take your bag. So you notice I got my hole's this big. It's not way out here. It's this big, just big enough to kind of get my hands in there. And you want to curl it up. Curl it up. And find an eel. Grab them. See, I'm grabbing them on the outside with the bag. These are really live eels. So they're local eels. The local eels are the best, man. Sometimes they get the eels from Maine, but if you can get a tackle shop where they have local eels, they're better. So you want to grab the eel. Find the eel. Sometimes it's harder when they're feisty. You want to make sure the other eels are on the bottom. Then you want to grab right on the side of them. Right on the side of their gills. And grab freaking tight. See, all the other eels are down here. I got this guy right here. He's grabbed tight. So now, I got my hook ready and everything. So now it's through the lower jaw, right there, and out the eye socket. And then you just kind of, that's it. Now you want to cast them right away. If you have to walk to the beach, if you're walking, keep his tail on the ground. If you do that, he's not going to curl up. Now you're going to cast it pretty much like a plug. You're gonna get your contact right away, and you wanna keep your rod up here, not down here. Because when you get that hit, you wanna drop your rod. So your rod's up here, and you're reeling really, really slow, just like reeling a plug. Now here's the thing. If you think you have a hit, it's not a hit. When you get a hit, you're gonna know it. It's gonna be boom, it's gonna feel just like that, like somebody slapped your rod with their fist. So when you get that, you're gonna do one or two things. You're gonna either bow down to the eel immediately, and when you do it, it's got to be immediate. It can't be like this. Oh, I got a hit. It can't be like that. It's, let me cast them out again, I'll show you. It can't, so when you get that hit, when he really hammers it, it's immediate. It's, and you extend. See how I'm extending? It's not like this. You gotta take your left arm, your hands down here, and you're extending all the way. And then the key when you do that is, you gotta stay down. You stay down until you feel his weight. When you feel his weight, you're rotting, you'll feel his weight, and then when you hit him, I can't do it with this eel in the water, but when you hit him, you're down, you're bowing down, you hit him, boom! You know, you really want to drive that hook in his mouth. And sometimes they're on right away. Obviously, don't drop your, if he's on, don't drop your rod, because then you're not waiting. If he's on right away, you're just going to set the hook. I had one customer one time, we're on a trophy trip, and in the rocks in Montauk, I set my drag really, really tight when eeling. Because it's just a single hook, you want to get the fish out of the rocks, so I have it really tight. So he had a hit, fish on, I hear drag peeling out, and he's like this, waiting. He's like, when do I set the hook? I'm like, set it, man. He missed that fish. Oh, that was a good fish. I'll never forget it. So that's it. You know, when it's on, if he's on right away, you're setting the hook right away. If you feel that hit, He's not on. I mean, you got to make a split second decision. And remember, it's immediate drop. It's, and you extend, and now you stay down until you feel his weight. When you feel his weight, that's when you hit him. So a lot of guys will cast the eel. A lot of guys cast wrong in the first place. When you cast, your plug or your eel should definitely not go on like, be going like this and looping around and going back. If you do that with a plug, a lot of times I've seen rods break, but with the eel, it's gonna come back, when you're coming back and there's slack in your back cast, on the forward cast, it's gonna pick up that slack and the eel's gonna probably fly off. So it's gotta be a smooth. If you're a guy like me, I mean, I start my cast from here and I come back, but it's a smooth transition, you know? It's a smooth transition with the eel. There's no slack when I come back and go forward. So what I would recommend most people do is just come back here, stop. Make sure your eel or your plug is stopped, square out, and then go forward. And you won't have a problem. Because if you're one of these guys that do this, the eel's gonna pop off. But you're gonna cast it. I mean, put power into the cast. Don't feel because you're casting this big eel. If your rod can't handle it, then get a new rod. I mean, if you got like a 2.5 ounce eel up on there and your rod can't handle a 2.5 ounce eel, then you should be using a different rod. But you know, I mean, put power into it. I mean, watch, I'll put a little power into this cast. I mean, you can really, you know, get it out there. Your goal is to get it out there in the surf. You know, you don't want to mansy-pansy around and just expect to catch anything. Although sometimes the fish are right in front of you. Say now I'm done with the eel, right? So you can put it back in your live well and he will stay potentially for weeks, right? So, but I'm gonna let this one go. We discussed this a lot on the surfratsball.com and the Surfcaster's Journal has extensive stuff on eeling. On the surfratsball.com, you get my log, there's all kinds of structure, and we really get into stuff like that, really in-depth conversations. So please consider becoming a member.